Well, TV viewers around the world fell under the spell of Bewitched when it premiered in the early 60s. The series centred around the good-hearted witch Samantha, her mortal husband Darren, and daughter Tabitha, who was played by Erin Murphy. Erin is one of the last remaining cast members of the show who is still around, and Craig Bennett caught up with her for this Australian TV exclusive.
Erin Murphy has been bewitching us since she was a toddler. The gorgeous two-year-old was already working in television commercials when she auditioned for the role of Tabitha Stevens.
They wanted someone who really looked like Elizabeth Montgomery, so they did a huge search, and they were mainly auditioning twins. I have a fraternal twin sister, Diane. There were child labor laws, so a baby is only allowed to work so many hours. But as fraternal twins, we really don't look that much alike. We were the same size, had the same color hair, but our faces really weren't that much alike. So they would show me for the close-ups, and they'd show my sister from the back or from a distance. And then after the first year or two, then they eased her out of the show and I took over the part.
Oh my, she has grown.
Erin had an instant bond with her TV family.
I loved all the actors like they were family members. I thought of Elizabeth Montgomery, I called her Mantha Mommy, since I couldn't say Samantha. And I called Dick York and Dick Sergeant Darren Daddy, and I called Agnes Moorehead Grandmama. And she was like my grandma that I saw every single day.
Elizabeth Montgomery, your TV mum, what was she really like?
She was fun. She was beautiful and smart and really funny, and she loved the horse races, so she'd always have the racing forms there on set,
really?
And I'd help her pick out the winners for the day. And a lot of people who knew Elizabeth and who know me are astounded how much I'm like her, and I think I probably picked up some of that on set.
And then there were her TV dads, Dick York, then Dick Sargent.
Dick York had hurt his back early on in his acting career, so it was something that never got better, and he had kind of a deteriorating spine, so he was in a lot of pain. The last season that Dick York was on the show, they had to write him out of episodes because he wasn't doing well. So I think the last season there were maybe 7 episodes where we didn't even have the character of Darren. And one day he had a seizure on set, and that was it. So they replaced him with Dick Sargent.
What is going on here?
And then there was the queen of meddling mother-in-laws, the very colourful Endora, played by the brilliant Agnes Moorehead.
In retrospect, she was probably my favourite, and it could be because I had grandparents who lived in other states that I didn't see often, and she was like my grandma, and she didn't have grandchildren, so I was like her granddaughter, and we had a really fun relationship. And I thought she was so colourful and beautiful and just really a lot of fun.
But she was nothing like the kind of bitchy, witchy character she played on.
Oh, no, she was lovely. It's funny because people frequently ask, were you afraid of Agnes Moorehead? Wasn't she awful? And no, she was so lovely. And as a child, the fact that she was so colorful just made her so much more beautiful, because kids like the red hair and the purple and green dresses. And she was great.
Mommy!
Oh, Tabitha.
The Bewitched set was a magical place for young Erin.
There would be episodes where we would have a baby elephant there, and it was painted with polka dots. And I was really young, and I absolutely remember being there with the baby elephants.
Samantha's nose twitch became her signature move, and Erin can now finally set the story straight.
It was sort of a nervous habit that she had. She didn't wiggle her nose, she's actually wiggling her upper lip, and they would film it at a slow speed and play it back at a fast speed. So even she couldn't do it exactly the way it appears on TV.
Were you able to duplicate that?
It was decided from the very beginning when I started, I was not quite 2, that since I was a little witch, I wouldn't be able to twitch my nose like a big witch, so they had me use my finger to wiggle my nose.
So can you do that and show me how you do it?
Only for Australia.
We love you for it. Oh, wow, there we have it.
Bewitched ended after 8 seasons, and the cast was rocked when Elizabeth Montgomery succumbed to cancer in 1995.
She was diagnosed very late. She'd had some symptoms and chose to ignore them, and by the time she was diagnosed, it was really too late to do anything. So it was very, very fast.
The idea of a big screen version of Bewitched bounced around Hollywood for decades, and 10 years ago, Nicole Kidman wiggled her nose into the lead role.
I may be in the minority. I really enjoyed the Bewitched movie. I thought it was charming. I thought Nicole Kidman was lovely in it. I thought it was funny and sweet. It's a misconception around the world that it was a failure. It made over $100 million. It was a lighthearted, sweet comedy. I mean, I enjoyed it. I've seen it more than once. I went to the premiere, and I stand by that. I think it was well done.
So, could there be a reboot of the TV series?
There have been scripts over the years, and I've read them, and even when Elizabeth Montgomery was still alive, a script would come, we'd all read it, we'd say, no, because, I don't know, I think The Bewitched was so good, and it's held up so well, and people truly love the show. Unless they come up with a kind of a remake that's as good as the original, or kind of lends something where oh, people wondered what happened to my character, and this kind of ties it up. Unless it's a good project, I wouldn't do it.
More than five decades after we first fell under its spell, Bewitched hasn't lost any of its magic, nor has Erin.
Do you think after all of these years, Erin, that you might still have some of Tabitha's powers just tucked away somewhere?
Anything's possible.
I mean, it's a hot day here in Los Angeles.
It's 100 degrees in California today, and champagne is always called for. Cheers.
Tabitha.
I've got to say, Greg, that was actually champagne comedy.
I have to say, Erin Murphy is absolutely gorgeous. Hard to believe she's 51.
Wow.
And do you realise when Bewitched ended, she went on to do a whole lot of things. First of all, she went to school because she was only eight when the show finished. She was wanted for the Waltons, and she thought, no, she just wanted to go on and have a life at school and do, you know, Girl Scouts
stuff.
And things like that, normal stuff. Then she went on to become a makeup artist and she became a casting director. Do you realise she became a stunt double for the likes of Virginia Madsen and Melissa Leo? She's a mum of six. In fact, six boys.
Goodness.
Six boys. And in fact, her second youngest son has autism, and she's a great advocate for autistic causes, for autism. Incredible woman, really just so beautiful. And she wants to come to Australia. We should do our darnest together. It's on her dream list.
We'd love to have her on the show. Beautiful story, Craigie. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah.